joining us now to answer your prep questions is Dr. Kim Hammond. Good morning, Dr. Hammond. Who do we have here?
This is Izzy. Look at that face. This is a...
I know.
This is one of those dogs. It's a great dog.
Izzy is a
Shepherd Lab mix. And it's just A+. It's got his Mano Schwartz fur coat on today, too.
He does. This is a beautiful fur. He's so soft.
It is a beautiful fur.
Well, cuddly. He'd probably cuddle me. All right, we've got some pet questions. One of them is, what should you do if you find a stray kitten?
All right, this is a really interesting question this time of year. You know, there are a lot of, this is kitty season, and it's also bunny season. There are lots of little baby kittens and little baby bunnies that you're going to find, wild ones, out in your neighborhood. Don't pick them up. Mom is probably not there because she's wandering off trying to find food. She's around. She knows you're there. Leave them there and call the authorities. Call the proper people to come and take the whole family, the mom and the babies. Because sometimes what happens is you take the babies away from the mother and they don't get the necessary colostrum. They don't get the necessary antibodies from the milk. It's a nightmare. The other thing is you want to make sure that you spay or neuter mom and dad. So you call the right people. There are trap and neuter and release people out there.
Now, you speak of that, it's almost like an actual baby needing certain antibodies from her mother and so forth when she's born, like an actual
human baby. Right. That's exactly right. And the other thing is, you know, some of these little babies have to be fed every couple of hours. You know, mama does that. You know, the manpower to do that is just not, it doesn't exist. So
very good points to bring up. We've got another one. Okay. It says, our two-year-old toy poodle chews on her paws a lot. Is there anything we can give her or put on her to stop her from chewing her paws?
Yeah, you know, that's going to exacerbate right now in the spring. That's called atopy, A-T-O-P-Y, and we talk about that a lot. That's an allergy. That's an actual allergy.
Oh.
They breathe in whatever is making them allergic, and their target organ is their skin, and they just gnaw, gnaw, gnaw. You have to go to your veterinarian about this. He's going to give you a product probably that'll be a bit palliative initially, that you know, that to treat it locally, but if it isn't properly managed, it can be a mess, and so you might have to use oral antibiotics and steroids.
All right.
That's a mess.
And I think we have one more question.
Okay.
My four-year-old Yorkie has recently started drinking an unusually large amount of water. He's always been healthy. What could be the cause? Should I start limiting his water intake?
But definitely don't limit the water intake, and definitely go to your veterinarian. You know, if you wouldn't think a four-year-old animal could be a diabetic or have renal disease, but it could, and you want to eliminate that initially. And if you eliminate that, then you can figure out something that's easier. But definitely go to your veterinarian.
All right. Always good advice from Dr. Ken Hammond.